My previous class, I have shared with you this example. And in this example, we learned how to make a frequency distribution table using the concept of telemarks. Continuing further, let us discuss this question. Construct a frequency distribution table for the following marks obtained by 25 students in a history test in class 8 of a school. So here we are given marks secured by 25 students in the history test. Now the first question is, what is the range of the marks? Now you tell me, what is the, how we find the range? Yes, we find the range. How? Yes, highest observation minus lowest observation. Perfectly fine. And then it is asking, what is the highest mark? You can easily tell. And then it is asking the marks that occurs most frequently. See how we are going to write the solution for this. First, we will be arranging the marks in the ascending order, right? It is 9, 12, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 25. And we see that there are 6 number of students who have scored 9 marks. 4 students have scored 12 marks. And we will be making the table. Now we need to write down the range of the marks. Range of the marks means highest marks, which is 25, minus the least marks, which is 9. So 25 minus 9 gives us 16. Second question is, what is the highest marks? Answer is 25. Third question is, the marks that occurs most frequently. So you have to just observe the number of students, that is the frequency. So you see that 6 students have got 9 marks. So which marks has the highest frequency? The highest frequency is 6 and the marks are 9. Okay. Today I'm going to discuss with you another concept here in the chapter statistics. It says grouping of data. What do we mean by grouping of data and why we need to group the data? Now, to overcome the difficulty of handling large number of data, say if you have 20 observations, it is fine. If you have 25 observations, it is fine. Say you have 50 observations, that is okay. You can handle it manually. But if the number of observations are 100, or 500 or 1000 or more than that, then how do you know, handle the data? So for that, we need to group the data. So we divide the raw data into convenient number of groups and obtain the frequency distribution of the number of observations which falls in each group. And this type of presentation of data is known as grouped frequency distribution, right? Say, for example, consider this one. Here, observe closely. This is the same question which we did here. I'm taking you back to this rainfall example. It is this example. Here, this data has been now grouped like this. So 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15. What is all this? These are all called class intervals. I will be discussing with you how we write the class intervals, how we think about making the class intervals when some certain number of observations are given to us. So here you see from 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, such type of data is called continuous data. This is continuous frequency distribution. And one important thing which you have to note over here is, if we consider the interval 0 to 5, here 0 is the lower limit, 5 is the upper limit, and 0 to 5 is one group, that is one class interval. Also, note that 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, the difference between upper limit and the lower limit is same. And that difference is called the class size, or we call it as width of the class. So what is the width of this class? Here the class size is 5. And how many total class intervals are there? Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 class intervals are there, right? And what is the frequency of interval 30 to 35? Answer is 5. So what is the frequency of interval 15 to 20? Answer is 6. So this is how we make the grouped frequency distribution. Now, you need to write down this in your notebook. The class 0 to 5 means the rainfall occurred between 0 and 5 millimeter, including 0 and excluding 5. Very important thing. Here, you know, I am going back to the previous slide. You see 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15. This is a continuous frequency distribution. Here, if I say rainfall is 4 millimeter. So in that case, 4 millimeter will fall in 0 to 5. But you tell me where this 5 millimeter will go. 5 millimeter will go to 5 to 10. So that indicates 0 to 5 meaning 0 is included, but 5 is excluded, right? So 0 is included, 5 is excluded. Here, 5 in 5 to 10, 5 is included and 10 is excluded. So 10 millimeter rainfall will go into 10 to 15. I hope it is clear to you. So in 0 to 5, 0 is the lower limit, 5 is the upper limit. Difference between the upper limit and the lower limit is called the class size. And another thing which you have to note is the average of lower limit and the upper limit is called the class mark. So if I ask you here, what is the class mark of 10 to 15? So how you are going to find? You will say upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. Average of upper limit and the lower limit. So 10 plus 15, that is 25 divided by 2. So 12.5. So 12.5 is the class size. Okay, tell me what is the class size of 0 to 5? 0 plus 5 divided by 2. That is 2.5. Okay, now see this question. Here it says, study the frequency distribution table given below and answer the questions that follows. Okay. So we are given weights in grams in the first column. And frequency is given, that is number of pieces. And total 50 observations are there. Now the first question is, what is the size of the class interval? How do you find the size of the class interval? Yes, very right. It is upper limit minus lower limit. So 80 minus 60. You can take up any class. 80 minus 60, you get 20. 100 minus 80, you get 20. So class size meaning upper limit minus lower limit. So size of the class interval is 20. What is the lower class limit of fourth class? So let us see which is the fourth class. 1, 2, 3, 4. It is 120 to 140. So what is the lower limit of the fourth class? It is 120. Okay, next question is, what is the upper limit of the sixth class? Sixth class is 160 to 180 and upper limit would be 180. Next question, which class has the lowest frequency? So let us see from here, second column, 1. So 140 to 160 is the class which has lowest frequency. Next question, what is the class mark? Let me see. What is the class mark of the class 100 to 120? So what will be the class mark? Very simple. 100 plus 120 divided by 2. It is the average of lower limit and the upper limit. So answer is 110. I hope this question is clear to all of you. Okay, so the next thing which we are going to study is about graphical representation of data. And I would be doing this discussion in my next class. So you have studied about pictograph and bar graphs, and here in grade 8 you will be studying histogram and pie chart. So there are frequency polygons and ogive also, which you will be studying in grade 9 and 10. So in my next class we will be discussing about histograms. Okay, so till then you prepare whatever we have done so far, and what we have to do is we have to learn mathematics by practicing, by writing. So keep doing that. Bye bye, take care.